Hello, I am Nancy Lund. I want to tell you about bicycling in Benicia. I'll start with an overview. In 2012, Benicia greenhouse gas inventory found that transportation emissions are a significant contributor of greenhouse gas in Benicia. In 2013, the Community Sustainability Commission voted to allocate a $20,000 grant to increase cycling in Benicia. In 2014, the grant was approved. And today, 10 great bike rides and walks in Benicia. Here is a summary of all the rides and walks in the brochure. The rides have been graded from easy, green, to moderate, blue, to strenuous, black. And each one tells you distance and estimated time of completion. We have four easy, four moderate, and two strenuous or difficult rides. Two of our rides are in the state recreation area. Two are in historic areas, two have waterfront views, two are in the Southampton area, one takes us out to Lake Herman Road, and the last ride is a tour of Benicia. Let's take a quick look at each ride. The State Recreation Area. We designed two rides walks in Benicia's beloved State Recreation Area. On the left, the first ride or walk is along Dillon Point Road. Enjoy the peace and quiet as you walk or ride. On the way back, if you're so inclined, take a left turn at the fork and go up to the Forest Diener Native Plant Botanic Garden. Walk on the paths and learn about native plants. Note, the green icon below the map indicates an easy ride. On the right is the second walk to Dillon Point. It starts just north of the Botanic Gardens. Once you reach the top of the short hill, you will be rewarded with a panoramic view of the Carquinez Strait from the west to the Carquinez Bridges and Mount Diablo to the east. This walk is part of the San Francisco Bay Trail as well as the Bay Area Ridge Trail. If you have a mountain or hybrid bike, you can ride this trail. Note the blue icon below the map indicates a moderate ride. Waterfront and Marina. These two walks or rides highlight our downtown waterfront areas. Go up first and turn left on West E, and you will reach the waterfront. If you are walking, turn left on Semple Crossing and follow the path around the water. Meet the bicycles on West 3rd, and then continue above the shoreline to West I, which takes you to Arneson Park, and then 9th Street Park at the end of I Street. On the walk around the Benicia Marina, you will see wildlife living amongst the boats in the harbor. Across the strait is the shoreline with the George Miller Scenic Trail. This area is part of the Contra Costa Regional Parks system. Note, the icons for both of these rides and walks indicate an easy ride. Historic Downtown and Arsenal Rides and Walks. Now for a bit of history. Look carefully amongst the old and new buildings, and you will see a 19th century town, largely left intact. These older buildings have been preserved with few alterations as a result of the Benicia Historic Preservation Review Commission and the designation of the area as the Downtown Historic District. Although we did not identify all of the interesting buildings that were built, From about 1850 to 1915, we identified those that we felt would give you a sense of what was here during that time frame. If you find a placard with a QR code, you can use your smartphone to learn more. Note, the icon below the map indicates an easy ride. The arsenal is in many ways a special place. Architecturally speaking, according to some historians, it has some of the most impressive 19th century military architecture in the country. Many of the buildings no longer exist, and those that do have been altered to some extent. When you arrive at Jefferson Street and walk up the hill, passing the officers' homes interspersed with like-minded structures built in the 20th century, you begin to see how the arsenal was planned, particularly after 1860, when the headquarters were moved from the Camel Barn area to the south, closer to the shoreline. Cross Park Road, and on your left are two older buildings, which were the lieutenant's quarters. And the last building on the left was the commandant's home. At the end of the road is the clock tower. It burned in 1912. Fortunately, the original walls survived the fire. However, it is now two stories instead of three. The guardhouse on Adams is unfortunately covered with stucco, obscuring the original brick structure. The bachelor's quarters down on Grant Street are also part of the original buildings. Note, the icon below on the map indicates a moderate ride. The community parks rides. We included these two rides for those of you who live in the hills of Southampton and Water's End. Both rides start and end at the Benicia Community Park off Rose Drive. We call the first ride the Four Parks Ride, as we counted the Community Park, Jack London Park, Park Solano, and lastly, Southampton Park. There is a long hill on Solano up to Larkin, and then on the way back from Southampton Park, up Panorama. However, what goes up comes down, so enjoy the downhills. The second ride explores the northeast area of Southampton and indicates a ride in the Water's End development. This ride gives you a chance to see the new architecture in this area as well as a brief look at the open space beyond. Note the icons below on the maps indicate a moderate ride. Lake Herman and the Grand Tour. The last two rides in the brochure are meant for serious cyclists who have the gearing for riding up relatively steep hills and longer distances. The Lake Herman ride takes you out of Benicia and along Columbus Parkway to Lake Herman Road. For those who want to ride off Columbus Parkway, going through quiet streets in the neighborhoods above, you can turn at Georgia Street and ride up the hill. For most, a left turn at Southport makes this detour palatable, as riding to the top of Georgia is a challenge even for the strongest. After reaching Lake Herman Road, you enter the rural part of Solano County. A small farm and cows are seen as you descend down toward Lake Herman. Stop for a drink or a break and then continue east. Although Reservoir Road is the main route, you can continue to Lopes Road and you will be rewarded with a view of the Mount Diablo Range and the Delta. Stop at the viewpoint on Lopes and Lake Herman Roads, and if you're lucky, you will see the Sierra Range and the windmills. Our last but not least ride, the Grant Tour, is designed to take cyclists through the diverse neighborhoods of Benicia. We included the Arsenal and Hillcrest neighborhoods first to warm you up for what is to come. Now the hills as we ride up Hastings, wind up Capitol, Cooper, and Cambridge, we eventually end up on Panorama. A quick descent at the top of Panorama and then a ride through Water's End. We turn off Rose onto Primrose and eventually end up on Oxford. From that point, it's all downhill to the State Recreation Area and back to the starting point at 1st and B Street. On the back cover, we give you some advice about bike safety. First, be smart. Be predictable. Be equipped. And be alert. Currently, we have one website available for you from the Solano Transit Authority, STA, and it will give you access to the brochure online.